All right, today, what are we doing? What are we doing? Chest press. We need a band. Make sure you got an open-ended band. So have a band, have a set of dumbbells for chest, for rows. Make sure you have a step or something to do your dips on. We're using an app board. If you have an app board, fine. If not, you'll just be doing them on the ground with me. Okay. We'll see. Where'd my phone go? I'll grab my phone. All right, we're going to start marching. We're going to begin our first round of 6 minutes of cardio.
Dedication to this weather.
So gross, so chilly. All right, now we're going to do a lean over, cross back. So I'm just crossing one leg behind the other. Good. Two more. All right. Soft jump rope. Start to get blood flow in all the muscles. Nothing to touch yet. We'll increase in the last few minutes. All right, let's do a high knee jack. We've got about 4.5 minutes to go. Three more. One more. Good. We're going to bend over. Bouncing calf raises. Bend over. Bouncing calf raises. Lean against anything you want. Four minutes to go. We got about 5 more seconds here. Good. All right, we're going to go. Feet, hips, thigh. Two more. Last one. Good. good. Let's go down to mountain climb. Mountain climb. Mountain climb.
Lean up against anything.
You got it. Elevation. Woo! 5 more seconds. Good. All right, let's stay down here. Get your heels up. You want to stay down here with your heels elevated. Sissy squat. We got a minute 15 to go. Heels up. 9 more seconds here. Good. Back to jump rope, a little bit more intense jump rope now. For the first 3 moves, we got a skull crusher. We'll do that with a dumbbell. Then we got dumbbell chest press, number 2. Then we got step dips, number 3. First 3 moves. So, you can use that to lay down. You can either sit down right here or lay down. Triceps, if you're going to do number 1. Okay, we're going to the ground. We'll be down on the ground. Yeah, for these first 3 moves, we'll be down on the ground. So, head to the floor. All right, here we go. Skull crushers. Dumbbell chest press, which you'll do up there. All right, dumbbell chest press, and it is just regular. Three moves.
Deadlift. If you're at home, you'll do it with dumbbells or a barbell. And two arm rows. So we're going to need our dumbbells for the next 3 minutes. Here we go. Floor to ceiling shoulder press. Make sure you're squatting down. Don't just lean over. Four seconds. One more rep. There we go. Strong hand over, we can under. So dumbbells look like that. Straight arms. Last rep. There we go. All right, move on. We're going to be going on our two arm rows next. Because it's mimicking the ab board. Yeah.
8 seconds.
One more.
There you go. All right. One round of cardio done. One round of athlete toning done. Let's go back to cardio. Right job.
keep jumping.
Come on, y'all two. Y'all are crazy, man. She's like,
Okay. Right leg back, marked up. Straight axe kick. Straight. No knee. It's all hip. Three more. Last one. You're unbelievable. Real good. We got 90 seconds to go. Three more. Good. Walk your butt down. So, down here. Your hand keeps coming back to the top of your thigh. One minute to go. Three more. Last one. And one breath. Okay. One more. All right, high knee with the bar. Last 30 seconds. Straight ahead, opposite hand, just like you're running. Opposite hand, and bring it in towards your jawline. Land on the ball of your foot. 10 seconds to go. Last one. Alright. Are you number two done? Catch our breath. We're going to start with barbell squat pressure. Dumbbell squat pressure. Put your dumbbells down on the floor. I think the first three moves. Thank you.
quarter press, deadlift, two arm row. Next three moves. Next three moves.
Darkness and starvation trigger. They're blooming to get your attention to feed them. So you have to ignore them and neglect them. It's like a bad parent. Am I grinning? Like a bad parent.
I see the light when I let
you them. Gotta neglect them so they'll bloom like a bad parent. What'd you say yours are doing?
It just seems like after I left it outside all summer and it really seemed to help it.
It does?
Yeah.
Oh, God. They love the summer. They grow
like crazy. Outside.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. There is no part of a cactus that doesn't love radiation. Ugh. But this is also not the time to move them. Because now they're sensitive. When they're ready to bloom, they're going to get, they're hypersensitive.
Oh,
they'll start dropping leaves and dropping flowers if you move them.
Okay.
So I moved them back in September.
Okay.
One more.
Sweating like crazy. Awful.
Okay. There we go. Back to our abs.
Got enough time for two more. Last one. There you go. Good job. All right. We're going to put everything away, then we're going to get down for sport yoga. I moved all the bins right here.
Well,
I had to clean. Mom will relocate when you clean shit.
Keep working it until one day you can pull the second side up. That's all that happened to us this summer. Could not do it at all at the beginning of the summer. Whew. Start stretching our arm across our chest. Put your ear down on your shoulder. Push it up. Side,
over
here goes down.
Oh, then we get persecuted with envy and wrath. But my head's anointed. There is no room for mistake.
One arm down, the other arm goes up. Over to the corner. Speak
to this.
Switch, put your hands down while the wound is over, reach in the direction of the corner. Separate your lotus, bounce your knees, loosen up the joints of your legs. We're going to go to the lotus the other direction, lotus the other way.
Let's get this ship up. Let's walk the fingertips out. Don't let it break your legs apart. Keep your legs together. Prayer together, press and round your back. So really push your spine into a seat. You're making sure your entire cervical spine are everywhere they're supposed to be. There should be no pain back there. You'll be able to touch the back of your head all the way to your traps. No issue. If you have issues, go to the chiropractor. Separate those legs, bounce your knees. Take the right leg, put your ankle on top of the thigh, right above your knee. You don't put it on your knee, put it on the thigh above your knee. So I've got my right leg here, I'm taking my right hand, grabbing the outside of the foot. You should feel the stretch in your back and your back blade, back and back blade. So grab the outside of your foot. If you can't get your foot, grab a hold of your shoelaces. Get a hold of something over there. Bounce them again. And then switch them. Hold up. This is groin, hamstring, and back. One of your muscles might be flexible and the other two are jacked up. So we're going to do big body movements like this. All stretched out. Back to bouncing them. Pull both of your feet together, big toes touch. Wrap your arms around your knees. Pull your spine until it straightens out and then look up at the ceiling. Straighten out your left leg, cross the right over, twist it all the way in the direction of the where your foot is. Go in the direction of your foot that's planted on the ground. Come back to the spine stretch. Bring them both back up. Big toes touch. Back up. Take your right leg down. Cross the left one over. Ankle and knee meet. Twist. Use your forearm to press against that leg. Twist your whole spine. I like your hands make it pretty. Let go. Flat. Bottoms of your feet together. All right. First cobbler. This is a trap stretch called the cobbler pose for yoga. You press with your arms until your legs lay flat. It's your goal. If they won't both lay flat, put all your body weight on one side. Neglect the other for a minute. And just get this part of your groin to loosen back up over on that side. And all you got to do is walk over here and press on this side. If you are flexible, keep them both down together. When I was in Jamaica, thank God I was there for 14 days. It took 5 days to calm my shit down so I could listen to this music. I had to listen to AC/DC the first 5 days. Then by the time I get to day five, I'm like, oh my God, AC/DC's horrible down here. This place only can tolerate reggae.
Yeah.
I was so hyper. Holy shit. Then you try to come back, you're like, oh God, I can't take American music when you get back here. Hilarious. Jamaica's amazing. Absolutely amazing. Okay, let me make sure. I got our groin, I got our inner thighs, I got all that, I got some chest, I got some neck. Let's wrap up with our big toe. Always got to work your big toe. So many problems happen with these toes. So you're going to take your toes, line them up with your knee. Okay. Sorry, I said that wrong. So I'm gonna move my foot back so I can put my body weight. So keep your heel completely off the ground and get all your body weight on your toe. You just rock back and forth on your toe. Oh boy, do the toes lose their flexibility? And when that happens, plantar fasciitis is coming to your home. Back and forth. Don't let plantar fasciitis creep up on you. You're just going to have to do this shit anyway if it comes. I'm going to do it ahead. All right, let's switch it out. Another one. All five of the toes are up and they are being worked. And all your body weight pressing down against them. Rocking it back and forth. Do a couple more and then we're going to get down for our meditation. Here we go. Nice. All right, I'll get our music changed and then we're going to get down for our 3 minutes of meditation. Okay. This is our final November meditation. Final, even though we're not in the Scorpio anymore, we're still going to finish up with Scorpio, which is meditating on new beginnings. Welcoming new beginnings in your life. Don't meditate on something you already did either. It tells the universe you don't believe it's coming.
Living together and praying, amen. Let's give fun some praises. A girl like that at the night. Back to the Jerusalem.
What? I love it, but what? It shows that you're going to be calm. That's not calm. That sounds like techno shit. Oh, that's a nice comment. No piano work. Here we go. The Fablemans. The Fablemans.
Thank you.